figure out your needs. And I was up here making, it's pretty much the same thing that I used the last time from the Dollar Tree. It's like a pot or a pan cover that you can cover up. So I used two of them, and I had found an old necklace that had the little small loops in it. And I took some baby nails, some real small baby nails about the size of a pen, and I stuck them down inside of the little holes, and I nailed them down into this. And it was a piece of wood that was left over that we had used for something else in the house. So I took it and I did that, and I was going to turn around. I was going to paint this right here gray. And I was going to cut this in half and cut the middle part out so I can sit it on here on these two things right here that I attached together from the Dollar Tree. And I got this from the Dollar Tree as well, with these flowers to go with it. And I got some more flowers that I have in the bag as well that I had got from another place. I didn't get these from the Dollar Tree, so I'm going to be using these on top of this with this. So stay tuned and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I'm back, and now I got some scissors and I'm going to like cut this almost, and then I'm going to take this and I'm going to cut it, and I'm going to sit it on here sideways, turn it around the other way so that it can attach onto it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the scissors back and just use one end and lay it down and just cut it so I can get that open space so it can attach. Okay, I had to cut the holes even wider so I can be able to slide it on, because I had to look at this right here was a little wider than the little narrow cut that I had made on it the first time. So I'm going to just dig into it. I'm making an extra double wide cut so you can have a little force to it. You need to kind of force it on. You want it to be kind of easy to go on. I could have just bought the little children's long thing that children play with when you go swimming. You be swinging around and playing with it. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. It's kind of like this, but it's wider and straight. But that would be too big for something this small. A little wider, and you have to take this piece right here and kind of lift it up and get it out of there. It makes a mess too, so I'm gonna let you know, it really does. It makes a mess. So take this on out. All right, so now I got it out of there. Let me see if I can and do some more apples. But make sure you don't cut too deep because you don't want it to come out the other side. It really does make some real good. When you get finished with the job, you're going to like what you're doing. And you do it the way I'm doing it or however you feel. Comment down below, hit that bell, and tell me if you like this video, and go and watch some of my other videos that I have, that I recently made on designing, and, you know, let me know if you like those videos. Comment down below. Don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button and that like button so you can get more of my notifications, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna slide this onto here just like this. To me, I got it on now, and I'll be right back, okay? Okay, so I had to use some zip ties to make sure it stay on. This is how it looked from this side around to the back. Because I'm going to be covering these up with some of these right here. But right now, I'm going to start using these. Leaves, kind of like they're both behind, stick right behind flowers or roses, however. I'm going to take the little paper off. Always straighten the little flower leaves up to where you can't even see it on the back. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to be filling it in with the rest of these too as well, because this has extra. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these like this and you kind of like spread them out because they mash in. And sometimes you can straighten them up the way you like them. And you take them like this and you slide it down onto another part like that. And it's going to look just like this, and you can turn them around and adjust them the way you like them, just like that, to make it look real full and pretty. And then you get your other one and you find your little open space that was left on the stem that you used your flower on. And then you take the flower and line them between them so it can make it look full. And then you won't just see all the little roses back. So, the little roses like that. And you take this and you just kind of spread it around and adjust it how you want it. And then you take that and you can turn it to make it look more thin like that. You can use this for, if you want to have a romantic candlelight dinner, you can wrap lights around it, or you can make this for someone who may want to have a wedding or at a reception or however you feel, you know, whatever you decide. So you take your, you find you an open space to fill it in, and you take and push them into the little, comment down below and let me know if you think this is pretty. So I'm going to add one more. Okay, so here is the candle finishing look. And so this is the almost finishing look. You want to add some more flowers, like really like leaves in the back here. And then you want to paint the bottom of this. And then you can get your light to hang right here to make have that romantic cozy look. Yes. Like that. And I'll be right back. Okay? And now that I am about to get ready to start painting the bottom, I have found some lights that I can put on here. And it comes with one of these right here. You can find these at some of these stores, maybe around Christmas time, or whatever you shop at. You might see these somewhere. And I can't remember where I bought this because it's been a minute and I had it for a while. You can put them inside of jars or whatever you want to do. And stay tuned for one of those videos. I'm sure you have one of those videos. Do is I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna kind of like stick it in here to hide it behind the little roses and flowers so you can turn it on and off whenever you need it. So I stuck it in between and I hit it, and then I take the little cord and I wrap it around like this on the back. I wrap the little cord so that it can grab and hold this in place to turn it on and off. Okay, so be careful because it will get tangled while you're trying to wrap it at the same time. So you might have to just put it all the way through. And don't worry about the lights going out and not working, because they are like little HD lights, like HD, or how you want, you know, those little lights. Okay. Let me get finished doing that. You want to make it tight, and then you want to come up with it. And then you're going to run up between the flowers. As you go, and you wrap it around the little one. on it on so you can see how it looks while I'm wrapping it. Dip it inside of here, and I'm going to paint the bottom of this. So I'm going to turn off the light. I should have did that before I started putting the lights on, but I don't know. I'm just going to paint just like that. Go all up under there. I already painted this side. Now you want to go all the way around with it. I have to hold it up because I don't want the paint to get on nothing. So I'm going to take it and I'm just going to rub all the way around. Let me see. I'm going to turn it around so I can see. And I'm going to make